guys. I hope you're good. I've got an exciting topic for my video this week, I hope. I just realised that it's been 6 months now since I moved on to my boat. And those 6 months have just flown by. But at the same time, it kind of feels like a lifetime ago, because so much has happened, so much has changed since I've been here. I remember back in the summer when I had my survey done. I'd sold my house, I didn't have anywhere permanent to live, and I decided that I was going to buy my boat. So I'd pulled out of the house that I was planning to buy and basically just pinned all of my hopes onto getting this boat. And then when I saw them pull her out of the water, my heart was just in my mouth, because a bad survey could have meant that all of my dreams had been ruined and I would have been back at square one. But luckily there was nothing on the survey that was going to prevent me from buying the boat. There were a few bits and pieces that needed to be done before she could be put back into the water. And then there were other stresses. I had to sort out my insurance and my mooring license. And I can kind of gloss over those things now when I speak about them. But at the time, it really was so stressful. It just seemed that the closer I was getting, the more obstacles were getting in my way. I was really unhappy at that time. By that point, I'd spent the last 3 months moving around from friends' spare rooms to hotels, sometimes not even knowing where I was going to be sleeping that evening. And I was burning through money that I didn't have because I needed every penny for the boat. Monty was in Catteries that whole time, and even though he doesn't mind that, I just felt so guilty for leaving him. And then on top of that, nowhere that I was staying had any parking. So someone had to look after my car. But it just meant that I was in these strange places that I didn't know, away from all of my friends, who really were the only thing that kept me sane and got me through that period. By the time I was in the last place that I stayed, I was just so miserable. It was noisy, I didn't get any sleep there. And some days I would just cry from tiredness and frustration. And then I remember the day before I moved onto the boat, I went down to the boatyard to drop off a load of stuff. And I came in here and just lay down on this bed. My hair was filthy, I was sweating, I had huge bags under my eyes. I was just exhausted, but when I lay down, I felt relief like I've never felt before. I woke up extra early on the moving day and I practically skipped to the train station, just ran and got out of that place that I was staying and didn't look back. My friend was late to meet me that day, and then we ended up getting on the wrong bus, and then the broker was late, and none of it mattered at all. Driving my boat back that day, my own boat, was just one of the happiest experiences that I've ever had. It was so hot and sunny, and there were so many fantastic things to see on the way back. And then when we got here, neighbours were waiting to greet us and tell us loads of different things that I thought I was never going to remember. And then the next couple of days just blurred past, shopping and cleaning and constantly locking myself out of the moorings. Like, that first few weeks was just a real honeymoon period. Whenever I was out, I just couldn't wait to get back. Kept everything spotlessly clean and in its proper place. And I was waking up really early every morning, humming along to the bird song. But also, there was so much to learn, and I felt really silly for maybe asking too many questions and panicking when things were going wrong. But everybody here was just so patient with me and so helpful. I mean, at first it was really unusual that everybody here was so laid back. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm a lazy bitch myself, but when you're growing up in London, there's always just the sense of urgency around everything. But when you're living like this, you soon realise that things don't need to be like that. And once you accept that, it's really liberating. One thing that I have found quite difficult to get used to, and it's still something that I don't really like, is having a landlord. I haven't really spoken about this in any of my other videos, and that's been very deliberate. I kind of worry that if I slag them off too much, they might cancel my mooring license, which is really silly because usually I don't have a problem with calling out people when they're in the wrong. And there have been some things that they've done that I haven't been pleased with, things that I've learned subsequently to moving in here, despite having asked loads of questions. I think if I win the lottery, then I'm just going to buy my own mooring with no bosses, no big businesses. But until then, that's just one of the compromises that I'm going to have to make to live the way that I want to. Anyway, as with any honeymoon period, it did wear off. It's like when you get in a new relationship with someone. At first, it's just full of excitement. You want to see them all the time. You can't stop thinking about them. And then that calms down. And you either think, what am I doing? And get out of there as quickly as you got into it. Or in the other scenario, even though that urgency is not there anymore, it's replaced with something else. They become part of your life without question. And you're comfortable because you don't fear losing them anymore. You just love them for who they are, even if they are a bit old and damaged. And it's definitely more like the second scenario for me and Snapdragon. I'm just kind of into a routine now. It's not novel for me anymore. And sometimes I get a bit annoyed with myself that I still have a lot of my bad habits. I can tell you the place is not spotlessly clean anymore, nothing is in its right place. But you're not going to change as a person just because you change the circumstances in which you're living. And it would be silly to think that you would do. But I know now that if I do want to change things about myself, the fact that I've got a secure home and I'm happy here will make it a lot easier to do that. Over the time that I've been here, things that I thought I would never be able to do have just become normal to me now. I find myself chatting away and using so many boat terms that up until recently I'd never even heard before, but I just use them so easily now. I've finally learned all of the names of the other boats in my moorings. I think I've learned the names of all the people as well. And I've learned a lot more about the wider boating community and met some fantastic people. Almost everybody has been great. They've been really helpful, really friendly. I think I've changed a lot in the last 6 months. I've become a lot stronger. Physically. I can do most of my heavy lifting on my own now, which is fantastic. And I suppose I've become stronger mentally and emotionally as well. I've had to get a lot better at problem solving and trusting my own knowledge and my own instincts. When you live with someone else, you can hide behind them, you can trade off with them and get them to do all of the things that you don't want to do or that are too scary for you. And not many people know this, but I get crippling anxiety in certain situations. For example, if I have to make phone calls, or if I've got to go and knock on someone's front door, but I don't have a choice now. I just have to do it. I don't like it, but I've got to do it. And the more that I do it, the easier it becomes, mostly. And loneliness. I went the first couple of months here not really feeling it, and then it just hit me like a bus. I've spent so many nights crying myself to sleep because I've been so lonely that it physically hurts me in every inch of my body. I've had days where I felt unwell or I've been so depressed that I haven't even been able to get out of bed. And when you're living with somebody else, they can encourage you to do things that are good for you, to get up, or they can just take care of the practical things. But I don't have that luxury anymore. I need to look after myself and him. And it's either do it yourself or it's not going to get done. I have a lot more confidence in myself. I feel like I'm getting to know myself a lot better and many of my values have changed. I don't need possessions to fill emotional voids. People put so much energy into stuff and it just does not matter. You don't need a 60-inch television or 100 pairs of shoes to be happy. I mean, this is just somewhere to live, all I need. Somewhere to sleep and somewhere to shit. I love my boat, but if I had to leave tomorrow, I'd cope. I know if I ever say anything on this channel that's negative or perceived to be negative about boat life, I'm going to get loads of flack for it. But I'm not saying that I don't enjoy it or that I want to quit. I love it. I wish I'd done it sooner. But it's taught me that things are just things. London is just the place. It's not the start and the end of the whole universe. I'm not ready for this adventure to stop yet. But I'm not scared for the future, whatever that may mean. Anyway, I think that's enough of my rambling. I hope I didn't bore you too much. I make new videos every Monday, so please subscribe if you want to, and I will see you soon. Bye!